News Channel 5 at 6 is back now with this. 13 days until Vermont's primary, and some differences are finally starting to emerge between Democrats running for governor.
Today, Doug Racine and Matt Dunn were facing criticism from within their own ranks and from the Republican they hope to meet in November. News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter has today's political roundup, new at 6 tonight.
The Democrats were all smiles leaving a Burlington Free Press debate, an event distributed over the internet. In it, Peter Shumlin reminded voters that Doug Racine's position on taxes helped him lose his first bid for governor.
I'm just having flashbacks to the race for governor 8 years ago, where we lost that race, and I think we lost the race because we weren't consistent.
2002 is a long time ago, and Pete Shumlin lost the race to Brian Doobie that year, so it's actually somewhat odd that he brings up that election.
All five Democrats think Vermont should use the new windfall just passed by Congress to avoid making teacher layoffs this year.
The resources are there. We should use them.
All criticizing Republican Brian Doobie, who thinks the money should instead go to pay down unfunded pensions.
If Brian wants to cut those jobs and send those folks on the unemployment lines, I think that's a huge mistake.
Doobie said Democrats ignore reality in a weak attempt to score political points. Meantime, Matt Dunn's new TV ad got Senator Pat Leahy's attention.
Matt Dunn's hometown sent him to the state legislature at 22.
That's Leahy in an old photo, used without his consent. We did not approve the use of the photo in the ad, nor would we, Leahy's spokesman said. Leahy's not endorsing anyone in the primary. It's up to Matt to decide how he handles this, as it's a situation of his own making. In Burlington, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.